Thank you very much. What do I have to say to the tourist who will see the exhibit, King Tut today? Maybe I have to tell you things about King Tut that you will not see in the exhibit. I am an archaeologist who spent most of his life working around the pyramids, revealing the secrets of the pyramids, discovering the tombs of the pyramid builders. And I never thought in my life that I would be involved with King Tut at all. But really, this exhibit, it changed a big part of my life to switch to King Tut. That I always say that I studied him as an Egyptologist, but I never really thought that I would be involved in revealing his mystery one day. Until this exhibit idea came, and was sent to King Tut exhibit to Basel, and after that to the United States. And this is actually when I began to think about King Tut. The first time when I received the CAT scan machine from the National Geographic and the Seamus Company, the first thing I thought is to find out how King Tut died. Because everyone thought that was murder, because you have this hole in the back of the head. It made everyone to think that he was murdered by an axe on the back of his head. When I took the CAT scan machine and I went to develop the case, it was amazing. As if the whole world was listening. The whole world wanted to go with me. Every media from every town in the whole world wanted to come. And I thought that I will never do any work. The tomb is very small. If all this media will come from all over the world, it will be a disaster. But I was afraid. I was really trembling, meeting for the first time this boy King, taking his mummy out of the sarcophagus and look at his face. And that day, when I arrived at the Luxor, and I did not tell anyone that I'm going there, I did not talk to any person one word that day. I was thinking of the minute that I will meet the Golden Boy. We entered inside the tomb. I will never forget this day. And before I entered the tomb, was at 6 p.m. A big storm happened in the valley. It was raining. And everyone was talking about the curse of Tutankhamun. I entered the tomb. I took the mummy with my two hands, and I looked at his face. That was the most beautiful moment in my life, looking at the face of the Golden Boy. When I took the mummy from the tomb to the CAT scan machine outside, the machine was stopped without any reason. And that was the first time that I thought there is something really could be called the curse of Tutankhamun. Why the machine stopped? But 1 hour after that, the machine didn't work. We took 1,700 photographs of the mummy. We found out that he died at the age of 19, and he was not murdered. Because that hole in the back of the head, it is the same in the mummy of Amose, the first king of Dynasty 18. And after that, the Egyptian opened it to put the liquid for mummification. But we found that he had this fracture in the left leg. That happened, an accident happened to him one day before he died. But everyone thought how a small fracture in the left leg can cause the death of his bone. I said, I don't know, this is what radiologists said, but it was in my mind, that's not enough. There will be something different. Then we began to examine the mummy more. And we found the real cause of this that I cannot tell you this morning. because I will say this in a press conference 2 months from now. And we found out also the reason of why Howard Carter in his tomb found 133 sticks. And I did examine all of them at the Cairo Museum. I found that King Tut used them. And that means there is some deformatives should be in his leg. That's something also that I won't say this morning. I will tell you 2 months from now. But what is amazing, that this young boy loved sports, he loved to hunt wild animals in the desert. And therefore the tomb of his wife, Nurse Maya, was found in Memphis. And there is a beautiful scene, maybe you saw in the special that was done by the TV here, of King Tut sitting on the lap of his wife, Nurse. But we found evidence underneath one of the houses near the pyramids that King Tut had a palace. He lived in a palace in Memphis. And he used to use this palace for the hunting of the wild animals. Then a man with deformities in his leg, a young boy, loved to do sports all over the desert of Memphis. The other thing that I was involved with King Tut, it's beautiful 1 year and a half, using the DNA and the CAT scan machine to reveal the family of King Tut. If you ask an Egyptologist, who's the father of King Tut? Someone will say Akhenaten, and the other person will say Akhenaten the Third. Who's the mother? Someone will say Queen T, or Queen Kia, or Queen Nefertiti. Where is the mommy of Queen T? We don't know. Where is the mommy of Nefertiti? We don't know. Where is the mommy of Ankh Esen Amun, his wife? We don't know. We have many mysteries. I always think that this Amarna period is like a play. A Broadway play, thrill, without an end. Then I wanted really to make an end to this play. For 1 year and a half, every day, we examine unidentified mummies' remains. Any mummy that the left arm was in the chest and the right arm was in the side should be a mummy of an important lady. We collected all these mummies of important ladies. We began to examine them with CAT scan and take samples for DNA. On the other side, we have known mummies like Yuya and Tuya. We have the mummy of Amenhotep III. We have the mummy of King Tut. We have the mummy of the two princesses that no one ever found out if they were the children of King Tut or not. Actually, we came through major important discoveries. We discovered mummies of important ladies that I never thought that we would. And as I say, in 2 months from now, during this exhibit, we'll make the big announcement of the discovery. But even if we revealed the mystery of King Tut, the mystery will never stop. It will continue. And therefore, we brought this time King Tut with his Dahul Pharaohs. He's introducing ancient Egypt. Actually, in this exhibit, there is 5 statues that I found in my excavations at Giza. One of them is a statue of a priest found next door to the Great Pyramid. The moment when I took this statue out from the tomb, I was the director of the pyramids at that time. It's a moment that I cannot explain to you. When you discover something hidden under the sand for 4,500 years, and you take it, and you hug it, and you clean it, and you look at it, and after that you write it about it, articles, and you bring it for you to see. Other 5 statues that in the exhibit I didn't explain how I found them. Step by step, I found first an eye of a statue. When I took a piece of fabric, I found the head of a statue. When I took a big limestone rock, I found they are 4 statues. representing one person in different ages. I'm sure in this coming 4 months, you will have adventures in archaeology, because you will hear about the curses, history, adventure, archaeology, and the most amazing, the story of the discovery of this great man, Tutankhamun. And thank you.